Hi all, Dr. Alsop here. In this learning objective video, we will be reviewing the afferent nerves that emanate from the nerve point of the neck. While these nerves are difficult to see in dissection, they can convey really important information from the skin and external environment back to the central nervous system. In addition to understanding which nerves afferently innervate the neck, and neck and shoulder region, we will speak regarding the spinal cord levels and associated spinal nerves that will be the source of these afferent nerves. So let's get started. Let's identify where the nerve point of the neck is. And we have a nice kind of dashed yellow circle indicating about the location of the nerve point of the neck. It will be at the midpoint of the posterior border, about the midpoint, give or take some, of the posterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. And so this is a common region for these cutaneous nerves to emerge in this region before spreading out towards the territory it will innervate. You will often hear this nerve point of the neck referred to as Erb's point. In anatomy terminology, we've really been moving away from using eponyms or naming areas after people. But clinically, this practice often persists, so you will often hear nerve point of the neck or Erb's point of the neck. Now, these cutaneous nerves are branches of the cervical plexus. And what does this word mean? What does plexus mean? It means a braid. So, let's talk about that. What does a braid have to do with nerves? So at plexuses, there will be a braiding or intermingling of axons from various spinal cord levels. So making nerves from the cervical plexus, these nerves are rarely from just one spinal nerve, but usually from two or more. The cervical plexus is derived from the ventral primary rami, or the VPRs, of C1 through C4. We will talk a bit more about what a VPR is in the next session, so kind of hold on there. I promise we'll get to that. Superficial branches of the cervical plexus are mostly sensory, heading towards the skin, so you'll often hear this type of nerve referred to as a cutaneous nerve. They will send signals back from the skin, or from the skin back to the central nervous system. These tend to be smaller and more difficult to dissect. The deeper branches are mostly motor or efferent, and we will talk more about these when we discuss the infrahyoid muscles, so the ansa cervicalis. There are four nerves we will want to locate and understand which spinal cord level the nerves are derived from. And let's start with the lesser occipital nerve. I'm going to outline it right here. Here's that nerve point of the neck, just to kind of get back into the groove of things there. The lesser occipital nerve is composed of fibers from C2 and sometimes C3. That's why I have C3 bracketed here. This nerve will innervate the skin of the neck and scalp behind or posterior to the ear. So think behind the ear. The great auricular nerve, which I'm going to outline here, is composed of fibers from C2 and C3. It will afferently innervate skin around the parotid gland region, and so it will also send branches kind of inferior to the ear, as well as, of course, anterior to the ear. The transverse cervical is derived also from C2 and C3, so I hope you have noticed that all but one of the four cutaneous nerves we're talking about are innervated or created by or originating from fibers from C2 and C3. So this transverse cervical nerve is going to kind of move transversely, as the name would suggest, and innervate the skin of the anterior cervical neck region. So basically all of that anterior neck region. Lastly, the supraclavicular nerves are the most expansive in terms of branches, with medial, intermediate, and lateral branches originating from C3 and C4. So you can see two here, also coming from that nerve point of the neck. It will have branches kind of extending all over this region. These branches will provide innervation to the skin of the neck across the clavicle, as you can see here, and over the skin of the shoulder. There has been consistent research that in some individuals, the great auricular, as well as the transverse cervical nerve branches may play a supportive role in sensory innervation of the mandibular teeth. This is a bit more complex than what we need you to know for this course and for our understanding of this area, so AKA, you will not be tested on that specifics. But I wanted to mention that it may play a role in terms of mandibular teeth innervation because your dental faculty may discuss this as you move forward in your education. So I wanted to at least mention it here, but mainly focus on the skin innervation or cutaneous innervation for testing purposes. Well, that is it for the nerve point of the neck and its cutaneous branches. Let's have a question to review. All right, the question for this session is, an individual notices distinct numbness directly inferior to their ear. So there's numbness in their skin inferior to the ear. Which of the following nerves is most likely affected to cause the lack of sensation in this area? Is it A, accessory nerve or cranial nerve 11? B, the ansa cervicalis? C, great auricular nerve? D, supraclavicular nerve? Or E, transverse cervical nerve? All right, pause the video if needed. And I hope you have found your way to the correct answer, which is C, the great auricular nerve. The great auricular nerve will serve the areas inferior to and anterior to the ear. So great auricular is correct. We know that the accessory nerve is not correct because it is solely efferent, remember? So it would not be an afferent nerve, so that would make that incorrect. Also, we know that it will innervate the sternocleidomastoid and the trapezius muscles, so very wrong ballpark here. It's not the ansa cervicalis either, which is going to be associated with those strap muscles or the infrahyoid muscles. So this is something we'll talk about in a bit more detail in that video. The supraclavicular nerves are cutaneous nerves from the nerve point of the neck, but these will innervate skin across the clavicle and the shoulder. And the transverse cervical will afferently serve the skin across the anterior neck. Notice I didn't put the lesser occipital nerve as an answer choice. The lesser occipital nerve would have been wrong, but its territory, which is that skin posterior to the ear, is awfully close to the territory described in the question stem, so inferior to the ear. And often, cutaneous nerve territories will overlap, so I kept that one off as an option just to be safe. All right, so that is all we have here. Please take your time to review these concepts and reach out with any questions. Have a great day.